Chapter 1, Integration. Introduction. Chapter 1 introduces the concept of integration and its applications in calculus. It covers topics such as calculating areas, the fundamental theorem of calculus, integration formulas, substitution, and integrals involving exponential, logarithmic, and inverse trigonometric functions. The chapter also introduces sigma notation for calculating sums and powers of integers and provides examples of using sigma notation. It explains how to approximate the area under a curve by dividing the region into smaller shapes and summing their areas. The concept of regular partitions is also introduced. Learning objectives. By the end of this chapter, you should be able to 1. Understand the concept of integration and its applications in calculus. 2. Apply the fundamental theorem of calculus to solve integration problems. 3. Use integration formulas and substitution to evaluate integrals. 4. Calculate sums and powers of integers using sigma notation. 5. Approximate the area under a curve using regular partitions and left end point and right end point approximations. Key points. Integration is a mathematical technique used to calculate areas and solve a variety of problems in calculus. The fundamental theorem of calculus states the relationship between differentiation and integration. Integration formulas and substitution are used to evaluate integrals. Sigma notation is a shorthand notation for calculating sums and powers of integers. Regular partitions are used to approximate the area under a curve by dividing the region into smaller shapes and summing their areas. Left endpoint and right endpoint approximations are methods for estimating the area under a curve by using rectangles. Real-world application. Integration has numerous real-world applications, such as calculating the area of irregular shapes in engineering and architecture, determining the volume of objects in physics and chemistry, and analyzing data in economics and finance. For example, integration is used in civil engineering to calculate the volume of materials needed for construction projects, such as concrete for a building foundation or asphalt for a road surface. In physics, integration is used to calculate the work done by a force on an object, which is essential for understanding the energy transfer in various systems. Conclusion: Chapter 1 introduces the concept of integration and its applications in calculus. By understanding the fundamental theorem of calculus, integration formulas, substitution, and sigma notation, you will be able to evaluate integrals and approximate the area under a curve using regular partitions and left endpoint and right endpoint approximations. These skills have practical applications in various fields, including engineering, physics, and economics. Integration is a powerful tool that allows us to solve complex problems and gain insights into the behavior of functions and their relationships.